Yo guys, what I'm about to show you was so secretive that I almost gate kept the secret from you. I learned this from I See You Nowhere. Shout out to his YouTube. I'll link his original video below. And what I'm going to show you is basically the new world of using AI models to model outboard gear that's super rare. So I'll show you guys some examples. We're going to run this sample, and happy Thanksgiving to everybody. Shout out to you guys. So here's our sample for today. Now you can get various free plugins. The one that you are going to hear most is Neural Amp Modeler. The only problem with this plugin, even though it's not a problem, is that when you load up what are called models or AI models that were trained on specific gear, the problem is it's a mono source. So if you guys are running your samples through it or your beats through it, it will come out mono, and that's not, we can't really use it like that. So I'm using a plugin called Genome. The only downside to this plugin is it's really high CPU. So that's the only downside. And so let's run this. So let me show you guys how this works. We're going to open up Genome, click on one of these little things, hit amplifier. Let's go to codecs. And what we need to do first is turn off all this extra stuff. So let's turn that off. And now we're going to go to where it says model. We're going to click on the folder, and we're going to load up models that we downloaded off the internet. You guys can find different sources. My favorite is called Past the Future. Sample or Past the Future Reverbs. They are the best samples I've heard so far. I'm sure there's other great samples out there. And again, what they've done is they've trained their models on specific outboard gear and the settings on the outboard gear. So let's go to Past the Future Reverbs because they're the best in my opinion. And let me load up one of my favorites, which is called the Galaxy 64 Converter. So we basically get to run our stuff through gear that we've never had and can't afford. Period. Nextly, click on this button, go to stereo. Okay, so now when I hit play, let me turn it off just to give you guys a comparison. So we have the game match here, so we're somewhere around negative 17. Here's off. Here's on. I'm gonna crank it a little bit so you guys can hear the texture. Here's before. It just adds like a silk to the sound that you cannot get with any plugin. And this is the what I was trying to show you guys is the sound of outboard gear. You know, when you're really getting the analog stuff, you start to look at plugins like these are just not even remotely close. But this plugin, because they modeled using AI and deep learning, they've modeled the actual outboard analog gear into these what are called .NAM models. I think it stands for Neural Amp Modeler. I don't know what the acronym stands for. And because they've trained it so deeply on these outboard gear sounds, you guys can run your digital stuff through this emulation of outboard gear, and it has the authentic outboard gear sound. So now you can really hear what the difference is in converters. Like EA Ski talks about converters, converters, converters. This is what you guys get to hear. Let's run it through an MPC 60. Now again, I'm not going to perfectly game match because it has to be loud enough for YouTube. Hold on. All right, so here's before. Here's after. Here's what we'll do. Let me turn up the original just so we don't have to keep going back and forth and back and forth. Okay, so I don't want you guys to be tricked with the gain either. And when you see people running this plugin, you're going to be kind of confused because they're cranking this up and turning this up. The long story shorter is the way they sampled a lot of these converters and stuff is when with a heavy drive, because they're trying to pull out the saturation that the units create. So a lot of the models that you guys might be listening to are going to be heavily saturated. So the gain knob on this is just turning up that saturation, basically. So you got to be careful with that knob. All right, so now we have a hotter level coming in. Now we can hear. here. So we're at, what is this here? Negative. Somewhere around like negative 8 somewhere. Okay, let's turn this on. Crunch. Now what we're going to do is drive the signal, so I'm going to turn down the volume output and turn the input gain up so that we're running through the MPC at a more aggressive level, which creates saturation. And now you can hear that ripping sound. Listen to the guitar, it's like a ripping noise. Here's after. You can kind of hear that crunch, and again, you hear it more so on the guitar. Let's try some different converters. There's so many, again, off of, again, the best source that I found. And there are a bunch of free sources like tonehunt.com, I think. You guys could download a bunch of free .NAM files, but the best source that I found is from our creators at Past to Future Reverb Models. They have the best ones. As you guys see, I bought the Black Friday bundle, so just in my opinion, that's the best value. You get so many of them. Let's try out a different converter. Let's try the Prism converters. The only thing here is that we can't change much about the settings, but in real life, you know, when you really have analog gear, you're not changing the settings. I even had a mentor, his name was Ronzi Silvestro. He has a famous 1176 blue faced one, and there's literally marks on the compressor that has like the settings for the engineer that created the studio. They never changed. So some stuff, even though it seems simple, sometimes it's just about running our sound through a converter or through the MPC 60 or through something to get that character. It's not about like twisting the threshold and all this type of stuff. So, you know, that's what I'll say about it. All right, so let's see what it sounds like. We're gonna push this one a little bit harder. That sound, I'm hearing more definition in like the highs of the bass. I'll say like the low mids, but like high bass frequency, meaning like anything around like 100 to 200. And I'm also hearing a little saturation, but that's really about it on that specific converter. So as you guys hear, some are more colored than others. Let's try a vinyl just to show you guys different styles. So we have all these different, I'm just going to arrow through the presets here. Now, very important that you guys, when you download these, separate your guitar amps and your impulse responses from the outboard gear, because you might be arrowing through presets and then hit a preset that's a guitar amp, and then your volume will just blow your ears off. So just be careful to separate the outboard gear models from the amp guitar amps. I'm just going to go through all these. Here's before. So you see it's adding a unique character. Some are more aggressive than others. Let's go do some converters. a lot of these are going through like mic preamps. Let's try the converters though. And I even learned from my mentor, Ron DiSilvestro, when I was recording, he was showing me how sometimes he runs his mixes through preamps. Like, I think it was either the Neve 1073 preamp, just to add more saturation to the mix. And they have also, they've modeled consoles on these .NAMM things. So you can run your thing through like an SSL, basically. Sometimes I notice a difference in the bass, so that's one area where I'm not sure how these models are trained, but sometimes you might lose detail in the bass, but that's where a simple EQ and boosting the lows can simply replace that issue. All right, so they even have SP1200. And I'm really gonna crank this so you guys can hear it. That ripple sound. Now I would use that more so on drums than I would on a guitar, but I'm just showing you guys there's so many textures to choose from, and this is what made each unit special. So again, we have Neve, MPC. Let's go through the Lavery Gold. Let's try this one. It creates like a depth in the low mids and like the top end of the bass. Now let's see what else we have. We also have dangerous converters in here as well. Gain down and then crank the input. Again, we get different sound, like different styles with different characters from each unit. So again, my only kind of, maybe it's just my volume matching, My only thing that I would do to most of these is just add a little more bass after the fact. So I might add, you know, simple like FabFilter Pro-Q 3 to add that bass back. Let's just try a couple more. Let's do the Akai MPC stuff. Now, the MPC stuff was pretty revealing, the way they get their sound. Now, let's find this MPC. Here we go. Here's the 2000. Here's what I'll do to make this like more obvious. Let's run this on drums. Okay, so that was on like entire mixes. Let's try this on some drums. Let's do these real quick. Let's run this. And okay, so I'm doing this in real time. Let's hit Control L. Actually, you know what we should do? Let's run this on, because this is too many stems. Let's just do a regular break. Let's do some Beat Butcher sounds. Let's find a clean one. I think it's called Rim, something Rim. Here it is. Okay, let's use this one. And we're gonna run this through, what channel is this? Channel 6. All right, now we're really gonna hear the detail. I just didn't wanna run drums because drums is kind of boring, like soloed. But now that you guys can hear the character that this thing adds, now let's really hear it on individual sounds. Again, the only issue I have with this plugin is that it's way too CPU intensive, which means I normally wouldn't use it on just one sound or another. I would use it on a mix bus, if anything. Okay, so here's the MPC. Here's before. That is such a difference, it's crazy. Here's after. Crazy, let's hear the 3000. Whoa. So just by adding this plugin, my little son's walking around. Just by adding this plugin, and we can get a lot of detail that fills out our beats and makes it sound more full without adding a bunch of other elements. So here's after. The 2000 had the best sound in my opinion. That crunch is crazy. Let's try some other older units. Let's try the MPC 60. Also, there's an ASR 10. Again, this is why I said the best company I found is Past the Future Reverbs. I recommend the Black Friday bundle. Go support them. They really did a lot of work to get these. So here's the ASR 10. Here's before. Here's after. All right, let's switch it. So it even adds like a film over the sound. I believe it's like downsampling. I don't know the sample rate of the ASR10. Now this one has a little phase issue. I don't know how to fix it. Here's another thing about this plugin. This specific preset has a little phase issue. I'm not sure how to fix that in this plugin. Other plugins have delay compensation, but this one, this specific preset just has a little phase to it. So again, he has compressors, he has converters. Let's switch this, let's put it through an Apogee. Again, here's before. Here's after. Crazy. But as you guys can see, the only flaw is that the CPU is at 72. So doing this on an entire track with other plugins is probably gonna be impossible. Hopefully my son doesn't press any buttons here. I'm gonna mute my mic. Let's run a couple more presets here. And you may be wondering, can you run this stuff through like analog compressors? The answer is yes. They modeled 1176, a lot of compressors. Let me go to some that I'm familiar with. So this, let's go to the Lavery Gold. This is what Gold Clip tries to emulate. Let's see what it sounds like. Again, here's before. Here's after. This one has a crazy bite to it. Let's try the MPC 60. Whoa, crazy crunch. Let's try Neve. This is a Neve console here. Again, hearing it on just drums is one thing, but hearing it on an entire song is completely different. That's why I try to run it through an entire song. Most of you guys will use this on entire mix buses. You're not going to be using it individually on sounds, unless you're doing like samples on your sample bus. Let's run it through a couple more things and then we'll wrap this up. Let's try the, what did I try? There's SP. Yeah, I did that one. Let's do, let's try, I don't know if I did Lavery or not. Let's go back. Now I'm just going to go through different models here to see what kind of sounds we can get. Not all of these are meant for a mix bus. I just want to say that before I press these presets. The last one here, but the Galaxy is my favorite one. I'll let you guys research and do more. Again, the go-to things right now that I use are Genome, the plugin. I wish it was more CPU friendly. And the company called Past to Future Reverb Models has a really good bundle with all of the analog stuff. I bought the Black Friday one. You guys should too. And what else is there to tell y'all? Thank you to IC No One or Nowhere. Man, I forgot my guy's name that fast. I think it's IC No One. Shout out to him for the credit for this. And then also, if you guys just want like the mono thing for like guitars and stuff, you could load up the neural amp modeler. In the next video, I'll talk about impulse responses. For now, we're going to end this video. Appreciate you guys. Subscribe for new. Peace.